So guys, today let us discuss the new concept, that is the pointer expressions, or it can be pointer arithmetic. So what is the meaning of this? We can see that we can do arithmetic operations on variables, correct? Like for example, int a equal to 10 and b equal to 20. We can add this, means a plus b, we can add like this, like right, we can add the normal variables. So can we add the pointers variables? Can we add that? Yes, it can be done. That is the new concept, that is pointers arithmetic or pointers expressions. So how it can be done? So what is pointer? Pointer is a variable which holds the address of another variable. So what is the meaning of that? We already know that. So what will I do now is, let me try to add the pointer variables. Let me try to add the pointer variables. How? For example, now let me declare the pointer variable star p comma star p1. These are pointer variables, and I will also declare the normal variables a equal to 10, b equal to 20. A equal to 10 and b equal to 20. Let me do like this. So now what will I do is, as we know, we can assign now in madbodiga now pointer variables ge normal variables na assign madboda. Yes, we can assign the normal variables address to the pointer variables. How? Using p1 equal to ampersand a. Already we know this, how to do this. So p2 equal to ampersand b. Let me do like this. So what will be the how it will be stored? How it will be stored? So integer text, as per standard, integer takes 2 bytes of memory, and depend upon architecture it can be varied. So what will I do? Let me store this in 2 bytes. This is a, and again 2 bytes, it is 20. This is b, correct? So now what will I do is, let me add this, let me add p1 plus p2. Let me add p1 plus p2. So what is p1 plus p2? Let me assign the addresses first, 1000 and 1005. So p1 plus p2. So what is p1 plus p2? Address of A plus address of B. Address of A plus address of B. Can it be done? Let us discuss it now. So what will I take is, first we will take the addresses, on addresses, on addresses. So what will I do? Let me take it as p1 plus p2. P1 plus p2. Let's say this is p1 and this is p2. This is p1, this is p2. Its meaning is p1 equal to ampersand a, p2 equal to ampersand b. Okay, I am assigning the a's address to p1 and b's address to p2. So let me add those. Let me add these two. So how it can be added? So 1000, that is p1's address and p2's address. So what will be the output? The output will be, output will be 2002, correct? So remember, this 2002 address may be available in your computer or it may not available in your computer, correct? Idu nimma 2002 address nim computer alli available irabodu athwa irdenu irabodu, correct? So that's why this addition operation on addresses is not possible. This is not possible. So addition on addresses is not possible. If you execute this program in your compiler, you will get the error. You will get the error. You will execute and see how it works. So next, what will be the next address, next operation? We have seen the plus operation, that is arithmetic plus. Now what will I do? Let me take minus. So what will I do is, let me use P2 minus P1. So what is P2? 1002 minus 1000. And after you done subtraction, yes, you can get the output, because the subtraction is available. After subtraction, the address will be available. So you will get the output. There will be no problem. You'll execute and see. So next operation will be, let me add like this, P1 into P2. So what is P1? 1000. What is P2? 1002. So as the same as our addition, this multiplication is also not possible. Okay, P1 into P2, 1000 into 1022, means it will be large, the output will be large. That's why it may be available in your computer or not, correct? So that's what the multiplication on pointers addresses. Remember, it's on addresses. It is also not possible. Okay. So what will be the next operation? P1 divided by P2. So 1000 divided by 1002. So what will be the output? The output may be in the decimals, correct? Output may be in the decimals, 0 point something. So that address, obviously it will be not available in your computer, correct? So that's why division is also not possible on the addresses. Okay, so next, what will be the next one? Let me do increment operation. So I will use pre-increment. Post-increment may be not possible in some compiler. So that's why what will I do is, let me take the pre-increment. So plus P1. So what will be the output? So what is P1? 1000. 1000 means P1. Plus means the incremented by value 1. So what will be the output? If you think the output will be 1001, it will be wrong. So the output will be 1002. This is correct. Why? Because as we know, integer takes 2 bytes of memory. That is scale factor. We already know this. So 1002. So in 1001, this 10 has been stored, correct? So what will be the next number? That is 20 stored in 1002. So if you increment by 1, the address will be 1002, not 1001, remember, not 1001. This is a scale factor, okay? So let me do the decrement now. Let me do decrement. So if I do decrement, so what will be the output? Let me take P2. Okay, so if I decrement this, so what will be the output? What is the value of P2? 1002. If you think the output will be 1001, it's also not correct. It will be wrong, because integer takes 2 bytes of memory. So the output will be 1000. This is correct. So we have seen that we can take integer value. We have taken integer values. So what about characters? Yes, it can be done same as integer. Difference is, if you increment or decrement, character takes one byte of memory. So if you decrement, only one byte of memory will be incremented or decremented. incremented or decremented, only 1 byte. What is float? Float takes 4 bytes of memory. As per standard I am telling now, as per standard integer 2 bytes, character 1 byte, like that. So in some compilers integer takes 4 bytes, float takes 8 bytes. Okay, let us take a standard one. So this is on the addresses, the arithmetic operations is on addresses. So let us see on the pointers, on values, on. So next we will see on values. So how we will get the values? Using the star operator. Using the star operator, correct? How star operator the other value find out for both? So if I get star P1, what will be the output? Star P1. Star P1 means the value stored at the location A. We have assigned here P1 equal to ampersand A, correct? P1 equal to ampersand A means the address will be stored in this memory, this P1 pointer. So if I take star P1, the value stored at the P1 is, what's that? 10. So the output, this will be 10, correct? Star P1 means 10 and star P2 is 20, because you have assigned here, this is P2, correct? Correct? So now what will I do is, let us do arithmetic operations on these values, on these values. So how it can be done? How it can be done? Same as addresses. What you have done in addresses? Let us take P1 plus P2. On values means I will put star here, that's it. I will put star here. Now we will get the values of P1 and P2. So what will be star P1? What will be star P1? Star P1 means, what is this? 10. Plus, what is star P2? 20. So the addition will be 30. So there will be no problem on addition. Correct? So what about minus? What about minus? What about minus? P1 minus P2. P1 minus P2. What will be the problem now? Can we get the output? Yes, the output will be minus 10. If you do star P2 minus star P1, the output will be obviously 10. It is valid integer. So what will I do next is, what will I do? I have assumed that the values are in integers, okay? So next one will be the into star P1 into star P2. Star P1 into star P2. So what will be the output? 10 into 20. 10 into 20. Shall we get the output? Yes, we will get the output as 200. No problem. It is valid. So next what will I do is, let me take division operation. Let me take division operation. Let me do like P2 divided by P1. P2 divided by P1. So if you write this line, you will get the, what will you get? So here we can see that, what is slash star? What is slash star? It is comment. How will you comment the line? Slash star, slash star, slash, correct? So slash star encountered here. So what compiler thinks is, this is a comment. So if you write this, the next lines will be like the comment lines. So that's why just put the bracket like this. Just put brackets. Just put the brackets. So what will be the output? What is P2? 20 divided by 10. So what will be the output? 10. Correct? So what about modulus? What about modulus? Yes, it can be done. So on values, we can do any arithmetic operations. No problem at all. We can do any arithmetic operations. Okay. So what about the increment and decrement? Yes, it can be done. So let me take the pre-increment, that is plus plus star p, plus plus star p. So plus plus star p means plus plus, what's that, 10, p means that is 10, the output will be 11. It can be done. So what about the decrement? It can be also done. So this will be minus minus and the output will be 9. The output will be 9. So all values we can do any arithmetic operations, but on addresses we can do some arithmetic operation. Okay. Now we will see some possible and valid invalid operations on addresses and on values. We will see now. So first we will see on addresses. So addition operation is possible on addresses? It is not possible. As we have discussed, this is not possible, correct? So what about multiplication? Multiplication on addresses also is not possible. What about division? Division is also not possible, correct? So what about the subtraction? So subtraction on addresses is 100% possible. So what about increment and decrement? So increment and decrement is also possible on the addresses. So p1 is less than p2, so it is also possible. What about p1 is greater than p2? It is also possible, and all these four operations are possible except this addition, multiplication and division. All the operations are possible on addresses. So what about on values? So on values we have seen that star p1 plus star p2 means the value stored at p1 and value stored at p2. Can we add them? Yes, we can add them. This is possible. What about subtraction? This is also possible. Multiplication? Possible. Division? Possible. Increment? It is also possible. Decrement? It is also possible. See, these are also possible on values. So what are the possible operations can be performed on addresses? Only except addition, multiplication and division, we can do all of them. So on values we can do any arithmetic operations. There will be no problem.
So now we will execute and see how the arithmetic operations can be performed. So as we know, the program starts with void main. So let me declare the pointer variables. So star p1 comma star p2, and let me take the integer numbers. It is a equal to 10 comma b equal to 20. So next I will assign the addresses to the pointer variables as p1 equal to ampersand a, p2 equal to ampersand b. So now what will I do is, let me do the invalid operations first. Those are, what are the invalid operations on addresses? Addition, next division and multiplication. Let us do them first. So let me use printf statement, printf percentage d comma p1. So as we know, let me print both of them, p1 and p2. So as we know, what will be the output? So it will display the addresses 04 and 08. Now let me add them p1 plus p2. Let me display it as p1 p2 and let me add them. So let us see what will be the output. Now compile and run. So as we have seen here, we will get the error message. Here The message is invalid operands to binary plus. So these are addresses. So now we can conclude that the addition operations on address is not possible. So let me do the multiplication operation. Let me do multiplication. So let me compile and run. So then also we will get the error, invalid operands to binary star. So the operands are in the addresses. Operands are the addresses. So now what will be the next operation? Division. Let me compile and run. So then also we will get the error. So what we have concluded is addition, multiplication and division on addresses is not possible. Let me do P1 minus P2. So the one here, the output is 1, because integer takes 4 bytes of memory. In this compiler, integer is taking 4 bytes of memory. And 08 minus 04, actually the output should be 4. It is displaying as 1 because 4, the output will be 4. It is a mathematical difference, but the technical difference should be 4 divided by the size of the integer. That is 4 divided by 4. So the output should, the output displays as 1 here. Okay. So let me do increment decrements also. Increment. Increment. So if I incremented this, I have incremented P1 only. So let me compile and run. So the output is, I have incremented. The P1 is 08 actually. After incremented, it has displayed as 312, because it should display 09. It is not displaying 09 now. It is displaying as 312. Four bytes of will be incremented, because integer takes 4 bytes of memory. That is scale factor. So let me decrement now. If I decrement this, the output will be 04. 8 minus 4, that will be 4. Okay. We can also use integers for adding to the addresses. How? Let me use P1 plus 1. So 1 is the integer. So let me compile this. So if we compile this, we can see here the output. This is P1. 08 means it is P1. This is P2. And 12, it is after adding 1, it is displaying as 12. Why? Because of scale factor. If we add 1, so integer takes 4 bytes of memory. So 12 has been displayed. So 8 plus 4. So I can use plus 10 also. I can use plus 10 or plus 2, like that also. So if we add, if you do like that, if I compile this, the output will be 48. I mean 348. P1 is 308, P2 is 348, because 10 into 4. 10 into 4 means 40. So 8 plus 40 is 48. So we can add integers for the address, and we can do subtraction also. We can do subtraction also. If I do P1 minus 1. P1 minus 1. So the output will be 8 minus 4. 08. Because of minus 1, I need to use minus 4. Integer takes 4 bytes of memory. 8 minus 4, 4. So if I use minus 10, if I use minus 10, then compile and run. So we can see the output is 68. 308 minus 40. That is 268. Okay. So we can add or subtract the addresses with the integers also. What about the relational operations like greater than, less than? So let us check them now. So what will I do is, let me take if condition, if P1 is greater than P2. So greater than symbol is the relational operator. If P1 is greater than P2, let me print some message p1 is, sorry, let me print as p1 is greater. And in else part, let me display it as printf p2 is greater. Printf p2 is greater. So let us check, compile and run. So the output is, what is the output now? P1 is greater, because as we have seen here, the 308 higher than 304, so the output has displayed as P1 is greater. So greater this symbol is valid on addresses. So what about less than? What about less? So P2 is greater, P1 is smaller. So let me compile and run. So P2 is greater now. So P1 is less than P2, and as we have seen here, P2 is greater. So this code, this segment of code is executing. Correct? P1 is less than P2? No. So the else part is executing now. So all the relational operators are also possible on addresses. Then the output will be P2 is greater. As you have seen here, it is 10 and 11, because character takes 1 byte of memory. So this is on addresses. Let us check on values now. So what will I do is, let me use printf statement, %d, comma, star p1 plus star p2. Star p1 plus star p2. Let me do like this. Let me use all the arithmetic operations in single program. So what we have done, we have done all the arithmetic operations on the single program. So I have done addition, subtraction, multiplication, increment and decrement. Now what will I do is, let me use the division operation. Let me use the division operations. So how the division operation can be done? Star P1 divided by star P2. So as you have seen here, see here, this line of code has been encountered. This line will be, and the next lines, this line and the next line will be treated as a comment line. So that's why we need to put the brackets here. So if you put bracket, then there will be no problem. So let me compile it and run. So as we have seen, addition is 30, 20 plus 10, and we have done P1 minus P2. So 10 minus 20, that is minus 10, then 20 into 10, 200. So what is this 11? The increment of A, that is 11. This is decrement of B, because we have assigned B's address to P2. So we are decrementing P2 here. So the output will be 19. So next, decrement. So this decrement, actually this should be division. This should be division. So the output will be 0. Why 0? Because we have declared it as integer. So when 10 divided by 20 encounters, it should be 0.5. Because of this integer, 0.5 has been truncated, only 0 will be displayed. We can also add or subtract the integers to the values. How? So let me do like this. Let me copy this first and I'll paste, and I will do addition on values. So let me do star P1 plus 10. Let me do star P1 plus 10. This is also actually addition. We are adding two pointers. Here we will add the integer to the pointer variable. So if I add this, what should be the output now? Let me compile and run. We can see here addition on value is, it is showing 21. it should be 20, right? Why 20? I am assigning the address of A to P1, A value is 10 plus 10, 20, but it is showing 21. Why? Because as you can see in the code here, we have already incremented the value. We have already incremented the P1 value. So that's why it is incremented to 1, that is 11, plus 10, 20. So let me do like this. Let me comment this and I will compile and run. Now the value becomes 20. 10 plus 10, that is 20. Okay. So what about minus? It can also done. It is actually normal arithmetic operation. If I compile this and run, the output will be obviously 0. Why? Because 10 minus 10, that is 0. We can do multiplication also. No problem. This is normal multiplication. 10 into 10, that is 100. And also we can do division also. P1 divided by star P1 divided by 10. The output will be 1. 10 divided by 10, and that will be 1. So this is on arithmetic operation. Now let us see relational operations. So if star P1 is greater than star P2, star P1 is greater than star P2, let me printf P1 is higher. And in else part, let me display it as P2 is higher. So let me compile it and run. So as we have seen here, the output has come as P2 is higher, because the P2 values which I have assigned is B. So B's value is 20. So that's why the output is P2 is higher. So all the arithmetic operations and the relational operations less than, not equal to, equal to are also possible. So all arithmetic operations and relational operations on values will be valid, but on address, except addition, multiplication and division, all operations are possible. Okay. So this is about the arithmetic operations on pointers. In the next video, we will see the further concepts. Thank you. Thank you for watching.